Hey guys, it's Eddie the Magic Monk. Today I'm going to show you how to build a robot that roams around randomly, as well as if you put something in front of it, it will avoid it and turn around and go somewhere else. So technically, it should never stop moving around the room. So have a look. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to program it. So I'm now going to show you guys how to program the robot. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a variable on the screen. And what is the variable? A variable is basically a container that you can store a piece of information in. And there are two things you can do to a variable. You can either read the number that's inside it, or you can write a number and put it inside the variable. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to write a number inside the variable. And notice that I don't have any variables yet, so I'm going to add a variable called move. Okay, so this move variable, I'm going to start by writing a number 0 in it. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a loop block. Okay, so the loop means we're going to repeat this forever. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in another switch block inside the loop. So I have a switch inside the loop, and the switch is saying we're going to evaluate if a certain condition is true. If it is true, we'll do this. Otherwise, we will do that if it's false. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the ultrasonic sensor and compare the distance that I'm getting from the ultrasonic sensor. And if the distance is smaller than, let's say, 30 centimeters, then I'm going to change what is in the move variable to 0. Otherwise, I'm going to change what is in the move variable to 1. Okay, so this part of the program, what it's doing is initially the move variable will be 0, which means the robot is not going to move. And then we're going to test whether there is something in front of the robot. If there is, then the move variable will continue being 0. If there isn't, then the move variable will be 1. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag on another start block. Okay, I'm going to drag onto the screen another start block. And what this means is this is going to happen at the same time as the first start block. Okay, and what's going to happen is I'm going to drag onto the screen another forever block. So this program will keep executing forever. And then I'm going to read the number inside the variable. So I'm going to this time read the number that is inside the variable. And depending on what is in the variable, so I'm going to drag on another switch, and this time I'm going to choose numeric, and I'm going to connect the value from the move variable to the switch. So it's going to evaluate the number inside the move variable, see what it is. If it is equal to 1, then it's going to do something. If it's equal 0, it'll do something else. Okay, so if the number is equal to 1, we're going to make it move. around randomly. So if you guys remember how to do that, basically we generate a random number. So we generate a random number between negative 100 to 100. Right, and we make the robots move around randomly. So we choose on for rotations or on for seconds, and then we drag the value from the random number generator to the steering property, so it will steer in a random direction for however many power level you want, for however many seconds you want. So the break at end property, I will change it to false so that it looks like the robot just keeps roaming around randomly rather than starting and stopping in between the instructions. Okay, so if the move container variable has a number of 1, it's going to move around. If it has a number of 0, okay, then what we're going to do is we're going to make the robot go backwards. Okay, we're going to make the robot go backwards. So the power level is going to be negative 30 for one rotation. And then we're going to make it turn to the right. Okay, we're going to make it turn to the right. So rotation of 50, steering value of 50, power level 30 for one rotation. So when you run this program, what's going to happen is you'll probably find that the robot takes a little bit of time to register that there is something in front of it. And that is because as soon as in this loop, when it detects that the move variable has a value of 1, it's going to finish running whatever is in this line before it evaluates what is inside the move block again. So what you need to do is you need to insert a loop, okay, insert a loop inside the switch. And I'm going to give this loop a name, let's call it random. And I'm going to put these two instructions inside the random loop. Okay, I'll make this a bit bigger so you can see it. So basically inside this switch, okay, it says when the move variable is equal to 1, it's going to run this loop forever. At the top where it changes what is inside the move variable, we want to interrupt the loop called random. Okay, so what this does is it will make this program jump out of the loop when it's moving randomly, and because we have the move block, we have the move variable set to 0, it's going to go down to the path where the move variable is equal to 0, and it's going to make it go back and rotate. Okay, so that's generally how the program works. Try it out. Hopefully it'll work for you guys. See you next time.